you got to realize, church, that it's going to be a battle. Every time you get ready to come to church, it's going to be a battle, Minister Rodney. Every time you get ready to preach, that's why that devil did what he did. Because he don't want you to give God the glory. But God says, praise me in season and in out of season. I want you to preach it, whether your friends are with you or not. I want you to sing, whether your neighbor go with you or whether they don't go with you. Some of your families would dare not to come to church with you. Some of your families would dare not step in the van and go to church with you. But you better have a made up mind that whether your family comes to go, that you're going to do what God wants you to do. Because I'm telling you, church, that if you long to praise God like you lost your mind, long to praise God the way the world praises the devil, God's going to get something done. My God from glory. Paul and Silas, they did not care, glory to God, who was around, glory to God. They did not care when they was down in the dungeon. Glory to God. There was no heat down in the dungeon. There was no air conditioning down in the dungeon. And some of y'all coming down trails and you want to relax and sit back and kick back, and somebody got to pump you to praise the mighty God. You could have been dead and you could have been gone. You could have been sleeping in your grave. But God says, praise me. I'm going to give you one more time. But you're still coming to God's house and you don't want to clap your hands. You're still coming to God's house and you don't want to say hallelujah. You're still coming to God's house and you want to be paid for everything that you do. But I got news for you, church. Whether you here or not, we still gonna have church. For the Bible says, upon this rock I'm gonna build my church, and the gates of hell shall not. Look at somebody, say shall not. Shake them on the shoulders and shall not. See how the praise, how it captivated the minds of the people that did not know what was going on. The people in the prison, they had no recollection of praising God and exactly what was going on. But I'm here, church, to let you know that when you praise God, things happen in the spirit realm. I said things happen in the spirit realm. In the name of Jesus. So when we're praising God, God is getting your auntie saved. When you're praising God, God is getting your nephew saved. Not quiet up in here. But when you're praising God, it's going to not only get you out, but it's going to get somebody else out. Say yeah. Say yeah. So then, when Paul and Silas was locked in jail, the praises that they had, it started, hallelujah, to shake the jail. But the earthquake came in the place, glory to God. And that's what God wants to do. In every church assembly, an earthquake needs to take place while God is getting the praise. Hallelujah to God. If I got to fall